Hello everyone, this is Shafiq from Nordic Bite channel. In this video, I am going to show you a very effective and free tool which can be used by educators all around the world. If you are working as a teacher or professor or lecturer or any other profession where you are working as an educator, you can use this tool very effectively in order to take classes via online. Now Google has launched a very useful and user-friendly tool which is like an alternative for the whiteboard applications which you can use especially when you are taking online classes. So let's talk about this in this video. First thing what you have to do is you have to visit a website called jamboard.google.com. So you have to type jamboard.google.com. So it is also an application which is similar to various applications which is provided by Google using its G Suite. So many of you might be aware of G Suite applications, and most of the applications which is there in G Suite is provided at free of cost, but with some limited features. And in case if you are purchasing the G Suite, the whole G Suite package which includes Google Drive, Google Jamboard, Google Meet, so many things are there. And in case if you are purchasing those G Suite application, you may get a load of features. But still, even though in free version itself, you have a lot of choices. If you are using this Jamboard, Google Jamboard for the first time, what it will do is, it will ask you to sign in using your email ID. Since I have logged in using my email ID already, and as a result, directly it take me to the user interface of Google Jamboard. In case if you are using it for the first time, then what you have to do is you have to just type your email ID and password, and you have to sign in once you type this website address. And you can see here it is showing like you don't have a jam yet since I have not created anything, and it's also asking you to create one Jamboard now. So you have to press plus button in order to create a Jamboard. So where I can find this plus symbol is very simple. You click here on the top, on the bottom right corner of the screen, you can see here there is a plus sign which will tell you to create a new jam. So just click on this new jam option, and it will show you a page. It's something like very similar to a whiteboard slide. In this you can create as many slides as you can. After creating one slide, you have to give it title for your Jamboard. Say for example, in case if you are taking a class in school for a particular class, say for example 12th standard chemistry, then you can give the name as 12th standard chemistry, or you may also give a topic name in case if you are discussing about a particular topic to the student, like for example organometallic chemistry or coordination chemistry, or it can be your any subject. Okay, if you are talking about programming languages like Python, so you can give any topic name also for your Jamboard, and you just press OK. Now by default it will be like a white screen. Usually whiteboard and all will be white in color, so it has given in that form. In case if you want to keep any other background, suppose if you want to change the background, you can also change the background into dotted line pattern or rounded pattern or any other color also, blue band, blue board also you can keep, or you can make it like a blackboard as well. So it is your choice. In case if you want to keep any other background in place of whiteboard, you can set it into your favorite color. As you can see here, this toolbox features so many options where suppose if you want to write something over this board, you have to click on this pen, and just when you press it a little bit, it will show you a lot of options in pen also, like normal pen or marker or highlighter tool or brush. So whichever you want, you can select, and you can select a color as well. Since I have used Blackboard now, so if you write in Blackboard, it won't be visible. So what you can do is you can select white color for this pen. Now when you start writing, say for example when you are writing something here, okay, so whatever you are writing, it will be shown. Okay, now suppose if you have a touch screen, okay, if you are using mobile, it will be easy for you to write. But in case if you don't have touch screen option, then it will be a little bit difficult for you. Since in laptops and all, you won't have touch screen option, so you may not be able to write properly. So you can see here, I'm using my touchpad now, which is available in laptop. So it will be very difficult for me to write. If you have a stylus with you, it will be very, very flexible in order to take the class. Or if you are using mobile, so in mobile also the same thing you have to do. You just have to type Jamboard or google.com, and same interface it will show in mobile. So you can pick the pen and you can use your touch screen, and you can start writing things. Now if you want to erase these contents, you have to just use the eraser to erase the contents what you have drawn. Now in order to select the contents, you have to click the select button. Now since these contents are written contents, so you cannot select these contents. Say for example, there is a very, very interactive tool in this which is available. It is known as sticky note. So this is one of the latest feature which has been added in this Jamboard. Sticky note helps you to fix the main topics or to highlight the main topics which you are discussing. Like for example, if you are talking about a topic called introduction to Python, so you can just type it like introduction to Python. You can give any color to the sticky note and you just click save. You can see here the sticky note is added over here. Now you can just drag it to increase the size. You can also drag and keep anywhere in this slide. And in case if you want to rotate also, you can just rotate it and keep. Now a few more extra features which has been added in this sticky note, like you can edit it again if you want, or you can duplicate it if you want to create the same sticky note again, or if in order to delete it, you can also delete it. Now in the new updates, they have also added shortcut keys. Like for example, if you press Ctrl C button, so it will copy, and again when you press Ctrl V, you can see here, so the same sticky note has been pasted here. In order to duplicate this sticky note, you can directly press Ctrl D as well. So when you press Ctrl D, this sticky note will be duplicated. Now if you want to delete this sticky note, you just press delete button. So the sticky note is gone. Okay. So whichever the sticky note you want, you can keep, and in case if you don't want any sticky note, you can just delete it. Along with that, now when you are talking about any concept, when you are teaching about any concept, you may require some pictures also to show. It can be from your textbook, or you can also download some pictures from the internet and you can paste it here when you are explaining. So for that, what you need to do is you have to click on add image option. When you click on add image option, so many options it will show. Like for example, the first option, what it is showing is to upload a picture. In case if you are already having a picture with you, you can just click on this browse option and you can pick any picture from your computer. So say for example, you can select any picture which is available in your computer, and you can just insert it over there. Okay, suppose if you don't have a picture and you want to download the picture from the internet, you can simply go to Google Images. You can type the name of the picture, say for example cell structure. Like this, suppose if I type any topic which I am discussing currently, so it will show you a lot of pictures related to the topic. You can just pick the picture and click OK or double click the picture. So automatically the picture will be downloaded and it is inserted over here. Okay, now in order to draw some shapes, and if you want to explain, like for example in mathematics and all, you may need to draw the shapes and you want to explain, or maybe suppose if you are creating like mind map, so at that time if you want to explain some concepts, you can use various shapes from this and you can just draw those shapes over here. Okay, so like this you can use various tools which is available over here. And then you have something called as laser. So this laser, when you have to use, means suppose already you have created Django and you just wanted to highlight something while explaining, then you can use this laser option. So this laser option will tell you to, I mean, exactly focus on the point which you are explaining. So all these things you can do. In case suppose if you want to zoom and explain, you can just click on this option and just hover the mouse and click on that particular position, so it will zoom you and it will show you. So this again, if you want to bring it back to the normal position, you can click zoom out, so it will again go back to the normal position. Suppose if you want to create another slide, so this slide is fully filled and you want to add one more slide, you just click this arrow, so it will create another frame. And once again, what you can do, you can continue the concept which you are teaching, right? So after that, what you can do is all these frames will be available as such. And after completing all your classes or after finishing the classes, you can simply share it to all your students. So what you can just do is you can click this three dots, you can download this frame as PDF and you can share this file through WhatsApp or the mail ID as PDF. Or you can also save these frames in the form of images and you can later on you can share it. Otherwise you can just click on this share button and you have to type all the email addresses and finally you have to just click done. Otherwise what you can do is if you want to share it to everybody, those who are using the link, so you can just change this option into anyone with the link and just copy this link, paste it to your groups where, or paste it to the students groups to whom you want to share this Django. So in this way, what you can do is you can share your whiteboard contents to anyone. And not only that, while using Django, you can also switch on the Google Meet option and you can share this screen simultaneously. And whatever the work you are doing over here, so whatever you are writing or whatever the images you are inserting and explaining, so all these concepts can be viewed live by these students. So in case if you are using Google Meet, you can share the screen and you can explain. Or in case if somebody is using some other video calling apps like Zoom or maybe Microsoft Teams or Cisco WebEx, or if it can be any app. So in all those apps, as you might be aware that there is a share screen option which is available. So you can use that utility and you can share your Django. So before that, you should keep your Django ready. And while sharing the Django, it will be visible live to all the students. So it will be very easy for them to understand the concept in a lively way. So it will be something like as if the students are sitting in a classroom and are just listening to the class, as well as they are observing what the masters are writing or what the teachers are writing in the whiteboard or blackboard. So it will be very interactive for the children to observe the class, make a note of whatever you are explaining, and they can also use these notes for their future reference. It is not only for the teachers, even the entrepreneurs can also use this, or the business people can also use this in case if they want to conduct any meeting or online meetings, and if they have to explain about any products or project ideas or anything. So what they can do is they can use this Jamboard and connect it with some applications, video conferencing applications like Zoom, Google Meet, as I said before, and they can also run their meeting very smoothly and very effectively. So I hope you like this video. In case if you really like this video, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Okay, till we meet next time, take care everyone.